Hello guys, welcome to my channel. In this video I will show you how to install Windows 10 on MacBook Pro 2012 without using Bootcamp Assistant. So that there are no obstacles in the installation process, you are required to follow this video from start to finish. First, open the browser. Then go to google.com. In the Google search box, type Windows 10 ISO. On the search results page, click on the Microsoft Windows 10 disk image, ISO file, download link. Under Select Edition, select the edition of Windows 10 to be downloaded. Then click the Confirm button. Then the Select the Product Language menu will appear. Under Select the Product Language, select the language used. Then click the Confirm button. And then click the 64-bit download. And wait for the download to complete to get the ISO file on your Mac. The Windows 10 ISO download process is complete. Now open a new tab. Then go to google.com. In the Google search box, type Brigadier GitHub. On the search results page, click on the Fetch and Install Bootcamp link. On the Brigadier page, click on Code and then click on Download Zip. For a more complete way of use can be read in the usage section. On the desktop there are already two files downloaded, Windows 10 ISO and Brigadier Master. Now open a terminal window. In terminal, run command cd to go to Brigadier Master folder. If you save the downloaded Brigadier file on the desktop, then just follow the commands like in this video. Then type ls to find out the contents of the Brigadier Master folder. Then run /brigadier. And wait for the Windows support download process to complete. As you can see, the Windows support.dmg file is in the Brigadier Master folder. Now minimize the terminal window. Then open the Brigadier Master folder. In the Brigadier Master folder, open the Bootcamp folder. Then drag and drop the Windows Support DMG file to the desktop. Next, I'll be setting up the USB drive that I'll be using for all of this. You will need one that is at least 8 GB. Now insert the USB flash drive into the MacBook USB port. Then start disk utility. In Disk Utility, make sure to select Show All Devices. On the left side, click on the USB drive and then click on Erase in the top right menu. On Scheme, select Master Boot Record. On Format, select XFAT. As the installation ISO contains a file that is larger than 4 GB. And for the name of the USB drive, I choose Win10. Then click Erase. Wait for the erase process to finish. Then click Done. Then close the Disk Utility window. Now double-click the ISO Windows 10 to mount it on your Mac. Then open the USB drive. Now copy all files to USB drive. And wait for the file copy process to finish. Now double-click on Windows Support DMG to mount it. Then copy all files to USB drive. And wait for the file copy process to finish. Now open a terminal window. Then type clear to clear the current window. On terminal, type disk util list. And then hit enter. Now look at Apple's APFS drive types. I will change the drive size from 499.9 GB to 400 GB. Now type sudo disk util apfs resize container /dev/disk0s2400g. Then hit enter. Type the Mac admin password, then hit enter. Now type disk util list again. Then check the APFS drive again. As seen, APFS drive size changed to 400 GB. Now close the terminal window. Now restart MacBook to boot Windows 10 USB drive. After the screen turns gray, press and hold the Option key until the boot options appear. On boot options, click on EFI USB drive. Then the Windows 10 window setup window will appear. Then click the next button. In the Activate Windows window, click I don't have a product key. Now select the version of Windows 10 that you want to install. Then click the next button. Now click on I accept the license terms. Then click the next button. Make sure unallocated space is clicked. Then click new. Click the apply button. In the pop-up window that appears, click the OK button. There are now two drive partitions. Click on the primary drive, not the MSR one. Then click the next button. Wait for the Windows 10 installation process to complete. Now configure Windows 10 OS according to your configuration. Now on the desktop there is already a Bootcamp installer window, then click the next button. Then click on I accept the terms in the license agreement. Then click the install button. Wait for the Windows support installation process to finish. Now click Finish button, then click the Yes button to restart the MacBook. As seen in the lower right corner, the audio output icon has a cross. This indicates that the audio output is not working properly. The easiest solution for this is to install OpenCore Legacy Patcher. So the MacBook needs to be restarted into macOS to install OpenCore Legacy Patcher. After the screen turns gray, press and hold the Option key until the boot options appear. Then select Macintosh HD. Open your favorite browser. Then go to google.com. In the Google search box, type OpenCore Legacy Patcher. And then hit Enter. On the search results page, click the link .ania OpenCore Legacy Patcher. Under Releases, click Latest. Scroll down the page until you find Assets. Under Assets, download OpenCore Patcher GUI.appzip. Wait until the OpenCore Patcher download process is complete. Once the download is complete, click the Minimize icon in the browser. Now open OpenCore Patcher by right-clicking OpenCore Patcher and then clicking Open. In the pop-up window that appears, click Open. In the OpenCore Legacy Patcher window, click Build and Install OpenCore. Then click Build OpenCore. In the pop-up window that appears, click Install to Disk. Select the SSD to be installed OpenCore. Then click the EFI SSD menu. In the pop-up window that appears, enter the Mac admin password. Then click the OK button. After OpenCore has finished installing to disk, click the reboot button. Then click restart again. After the screen turns gray, press and hold the option key until the boot options appear. On boot options, click on EFI menu. Then click the EFI menu again. Wait for the Windows loading process to finish. Now check again for audio output. As seen in the audio output icon, there is no cross anymore. So that's it. If this video is useful, don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, just comment down below. Thanks for watching and have a great day ahead. See you in the next video.